Hi everyone. In this video, we will learn how to reduce your invalid clicks and how to save your money if you advertise via Google Ads. After helping thousands of advertisers, the presented three solutions seem to be the best free invalid click preventions. Let's see how to save your account without spending any money on it. So, the basic invalid click prevention in Google Ads is the IP exclusion, which you can find in the campaign settings. On the left hand side, click Campaigns, select your campaign, go to the settings, scroll a bit lower, additional settings, and just at the bottom here, click on IP exclusions. Here you can enter your IP addresses, and for those your ads will never be shown again. Actually good to have it if you see clicks coming from the same IPs, but easy to bypass it with dynamic IPs. So, solution number one is to split up this campaign that we already have. It means we're gonna make four or five or multiple other campaigns out of this one by copying it, and basically we're gonna schedule them to start right after each other, and also important that we're gonna divide the budget equally between the new campaigns. So if this campaign has a 20 unit budget, then the four campaigns that we're gonna make out of this gonna have 5 unit budgets. So how to do it? Select the campaign, click copy, and then click paste on the edit tab, and basically do not pause campaign after pasting, just paste it and it's done. So we already have two campaigns using 20 zloty. Then let's do it again, paste, paste again. Now we have three campaigns, and one more time, copy and paste, and paste again. And here we go, we're gonna have four campaigns. So now here we immediately edit the budget, not to let them run with the higher budget. All of them. Once it's done, we're gonna need to schedule these campaigns. So what we have done now is basically created completely identical campaigns to the original one, right? So these, the keywords, ad groups, the ads, everything has been copied. So these campaigns are just as this one, exactly. And now we're gonna schedule these campaigns, right? How to do it? Go to the campaigns, click on the left hand side on the ad schedule, and instead of letting it run all day long, schedule it, let's say from, let's say this goes from 12 a.m. till, let's have it run till 10 and save it. So you will see here that it cut off this part and it's only running this range. And this is split the campaign, so this is the original campaign. Let's go to the other campaigns and do this with the rest of it. So campaign number two, ad scheduling on the left hand side. This will run from, let's say, 10 a.m. till 2 p.m. right? In these 4 hours. And then the third one can run from 2 p.m. till 6, and same with the last campaign. Then basically you split it up your campaigns, so even if someone is clicking on the first campaign and wasted your budget, basically right after the period a new identical campaign will start with the new budget, so basically you can save a little bit. Solution number two is probably the best way to prevent your account from invalid clicks. And this is called remarketing list exclusion. Guys, probably this is the perfect time to subscribe to this channel to help shift in order to receive tips and ideas just like this. So, if you set up a remarketing list exclusion, it means that you can collect all the users who have ever clicked on your ad into a remarketing list that later on you can exclude from your targeting. So, for those people, the ad will never will show again. In order to create a remarketing list, go to the tools in the top right corner, and under the shared library, choose Audience Manager, click on the plus button, choose Website Visitors, give a name to your audience, add your website, I will use just simply example.com, and click on Create Audience. And here we go, we created our audience. So now we need to add a tag to your website's source code. So in order to get this tag, click on the audience sources and choose details on the Google Ads tag card. Scroll to the bottom, tag setup, install the tag yourself, and here you will see the tag you need to place into your website's source code. Where exactly it's written just right above the tag. Once you added this tag to your website, basically it immediately starts collecting the users who have ever clicked on your ads. So now we created the remarketing list, now we need to exclude it from our targeting. How to do it? Go to campaigns on the left hand side and go into your campaign, and on the left hand side again click audiences, and at the top of the screen click exclusions, then the plus button again, and here you need to remember and search for your remarketing list. Here it is. Once you can see it on the right hand side, you just click on save. Now we excluded all the users who have already clicked on our ads, including those who generate invalid clicks. And last but not least, the third solution, which is the ultimate solution, is actually located in the Google Ads Hub. By filling this form, you can request Google to examine the last 60 days of your account's activity and possibly find invalid clicks. If they do so, they can pay you back a little amount of money, but it's better than nothing. Important that they only examine the last 60 days, not more, not longer back. And also it's good to have a weblog, because by having it you have better chances to get any money back. Another important thing that it's quite difficult to find this form in the Google Ads Hub. So even if I write the name, click quality form, it will not give you as a result. So this is why I attached this form to the video below, so you can find it in the description. So if you use these three solutions, you can save a lot of money on invalid clicks. Don't forget to subscribe to Helpship, because in the next videos we are going to talk about some free tools that can help improve your account and website performance and possibly decrease the advertising costs. Take care.